first song, the first hit we have to do.
I'm not
Just because I'm here and I'm real, I think, wow, that's a song written by an 18-year-old. It's an old song. That makes me smile. That kind of makes me think, thanks, Mom. Okay, here's a song that's not so old. Just the writer of which.
Flies around my head. Time is becoming more elusive as I go. Over there, somewhere. It's good to hear you. abreast of any developments. So this is a song that goes back to 17 years. Yeah, all these crusties. Yes, I wrote it in 1999. And at the time, I wrote it because I felt like the gun violence in this country was overwhelming.
Sorry, I'll clap all over myself.
It's true.
Right? And I'm so happy that I have this song to remind me that I felt that way in 1999. As things go from crazy to surreal. And I just wanted to share a couple of things, like when I heard about shooting in Orlando last week, what I noticed first was that I was not shocked. I was not stopped in my tracks. I didn't sit down. I kept going about my day. And what I noticed was a numbness. And then a couple of days ago, when I heard about the sit-in, what I noticed was a swell of joy and hope in my chest. So I want to play this song. I want to send it out to the Honorable Representative John Lewis and all the Congress people who participated in that sit-in. And it gave me hope and brought feeling back to my body.
Upon the field of
guys. Thanks, Stacy. Song that starts with the letter A. And I have heard it a lot recently because my daughter, I had to drive her to school and back every day because we live downtown and her school is uptown. And so we listen to tunes, and every now and then she wants to spin some mommy songs. But you know, iPods are alphabetical, so I listen to all my A songs a lot. It's an interesting random study. And Todd Zegus, your string arrangements on this recording of this song are exemplary. Really, really stunning. That's what I heard the other day. You won't hear them now. Sorry. Holy crap.
this show, and it's not reality. I keep trying. What's the altitude here in Annapolis? Can I have the oxygen mask anyway? Okay. The answer came like a shot in the back while you were running from your NASA, which might explain why years later all you could remember was the terror of the question. Plus you weren't listening. You were stockpiling canned goods, making a bomb shelter of our basement. And I can't believe you let the moral go by while you were soaking in the product placement. And where was your conscience? Where was your consciousness? And where did you put all the letters that you wrote? Thank you.
Sits on his 37th floor street and struggles to get down to the city he made me in. He allows me to stand, solicit graffiti, till he needs the land I stand on. And I'm a dark and virtual department through my pockets, the receipts, the bus schedules, bridge and acting poems, matchbook phone numbers, all of which laundering has rendered pulpy and strange. This change. Recited it to you last time I was here. Stop me if I'm repeating myself. Like you could, right? Like you could. So, just really cool book. I mean, if you're me, it feels very strongly that patriarchy, which is everywhere all the time, is kind of the fundamental imbalance from which many, many other imbalances are born. This is what feels true to me. And I think we need to go back to the source and address that fundamental imbalance before we can figure the rest out. And I have thought a lot about patriarchy and what is, things like how did it start? How did we get here? You know, you hear tell that there were times when it was different. And I read this book called The Alphabet Versus the Goddess. Yeah, that's right. You want to pick that book up, you do. And then you do, and you read it, and it's like,
The alphabet. The greatest shining invention of mankind, which begat every other invention, has a downside. And it's called patriarchy. And it's really fascinating. It's a lot about brain science, you know, and how the sort of the linear, logical, masculine side of our nature designed it all. It's just one part of our nature that's in all of us. The other part has been a little subordinate. But there's hope in this book. I mean, I was like, because it kind of goes through human history, you know, since, you know, seriously, since our heads got so big that the tongue is something. And it flips history on its ass, because it's like, yeah, all of those moments in history that we are supposed to hold highest, like the, you know, when everybody started advancing shit in science and literature and, you know, whether the Renaissance or the this, that was when women had it the shittiest. If you look at it through a different lens. So I was like, how does the book end? And it leads off in the age of images, which is the business of our right hemisphere, the intuitive, the emotional, the wordless, the round, and the cyclical, and suffering of the human race, the history of the world.
been in my mind recently.
Sensitive and
easily thrown off my game. All that bloodshed and pettiness just makes the world seem so insane, and I just feel drained. that was enough fun. For now, I don't know what the fuck with the set list is. Blame the set list. I think I was just so excited to be in the great indoors. I thought I'd take advantage of you.
And your like it.
Gracious listening.
32 flavors!
Okay. I am pleased. Thank you. time is not venue-ship.
Second verse.
I shouldn't really tell you this story, but I gotta tell you. Sorry. So I'm opening for Bob Dylan, one of my little stints. So I'm opening for old Uncle Mumbles. And it was like a, if this evening was a three-pronged bill, there was a wonderful band from Nashville, BR549, opening up, and I played little solo set, and then Uncle Mumbles and his entourage hit the stage. And one time I was standing beside stage watching BR549, you know, and whoop, there he is right beside me. I'm like, ah. And we start talking about, he's like, I like the rhythm section in the band. Yeah, they're great. I know about my rhythm section. They don't get the man. They don't get the man. They don't get the man. It's like, yeah. I'm sure they don't, Bob.
Thank you.
introduce to you my friends who totally get the man. On the drums, that's Mr. Terrence Higgins. And on the bass, that's Mr. Todd Sixpuss. Thank the wonderful Chastity Brown for setting us up with some beautiful music. Thank you. I've been blind you with my hair. amazing crew tonight. Let's give it up for the last four. We'll leave you with a little raucous one from back in the day. Thanks again, Israel. Pleasure to make up this.
Thank you.
Goddamn It Tour. That's what I'm talking about. Of course, we know we have a very important presidential election coming up. But there's all kind of equally important elections. State, local, we got let's vote every single time and get more people like John Lewis into our government and change this shit.
Thank you.
Like a man.